In this video, I will demonstrate how to obtain allele and profile information for your imported sequences. My entries are displayed in the Database Entries panel. All experiments are listed in the Experiment Types panel. For each experiment defined in the database, there is a column present in the Experiment Presence panel. Since 9 experiments have been defined in this database, 9 columns are present here. Column 2 to column 8 correspond to my sequence experiments. A colored dot is displayed if a sequence is present for an entry experiment combination. To view the consensus sequence of a certain entry experiment combination, I can click on the colored dot while holding down the Shift key. The assembly window can be called by clicking on this button. To close the card, I need to click in the upper left corner of the card. After cleanup of the assemblies, the consensus sequences can be screened against the online or locally stored allele information. In my database, the Web Services option is checked. When this option is checked, the consensus sequences will be screened against the online allele database. In this database, my sequences will be screened against the online MLST database of Nigeria. Screening can be done for all entries present in the database or for any selection of entries. I will select all entries using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+A. I select MLST, identify alleles. The matched allele IDs are stored in the corresponding character fields of the MLST character type. To view the allele IDs for a certain entry, I need to click on the colored dot in the MLST column. The housekeeping gene names are displayed in the left column. The allele IDs are shown in the middle column. With this option, the allele profiles are screened against the online MLST information. The matched sequence types and clonal complexes are displayed in the MLST information fields. This ends this video. Please tune in to our other movies where more functionality is explained. Thank you for watching.